वेलकम माई डियर चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। माई सेल्फ ज्योति कोकाटे, टूडे वी विल बी स्टडिंग सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड थर्ड एंड द टॉपिक फॉर द डे इज सिमेट्री। Before we start the topic, let us first understand what is symmetry. If a shape can be folded in half so that one half fits exactly on top of the other, then we say that the shape has got line symmetry. The fold is called a line of symmetry. It divides the shape into two equal parts. The lines of symmetry may be vertical, means standing, horizontal or diagonal. Here is a symmetry in geometrical figures. Children, do you know that when we fold a paper for making a paper boat and open it, the parts on both the sides of the line that makes the parts look the same. Similarly, here you can see in this picture, the fold along the dotted line in the rectangle divides it into two parts which fall exactly on one another. The rectangle is symmetrical with respect to this line. Children, now look at these geometrical shapes. If the two parts of a figure made by a line fall exactly on one another, then the figure is said to be symmetrical about that line. The fold along the dotted line in the square, in the rectangle, in the circle and in the triangle divide it into two parts which fall exactly on one another. The square, the rectangle, the circle and the triangle are symmetrical with respect to this line. Children, now look at the star. In this star, the dotted line divides it into two parts which fall exactly on one another. The star is symmetrical with respect to this line. Children, now we find symmetry in alphabets also. Look at this alphabet. Can you identify, children, which alphabet it is? Yes. It's H. See children, English alphabet H is symmetrical with respect to the dotted line because the dotted line in English alphabet H divides it into two parts which fall exactly on one another. Children, we see symmetry in nature also. What do you see in the picture? Yes, this is a picture of onion which we used in cooking. Look at the dotted line. In this figure, the fold along the dotted line in onion divide it into two parts which fall exactly on one another. So, onion is symmetrical with respect to this line. Children, what do you see in this picture? Yes, this is a leaf. When we fold the leaf along the midrib of the leaf, the parts on both sides of the midrib appear to be the same. In such cases, we say that the parts are symmetrical about the given line. Children, you can see the picture of a butterfly and The dotted line is called the line of symmetry. In this figure, the fold along the dotted line in the butterfly divide it into two parts, which makes the parts look the same. So, the butterfly is symmetrical with respect to this line. Children, now let's see what is asymmetry. Asymmetry exists when the two halves of something don't match or are unequal. Means, if two parts of a figure made by a line do not fall exactly on one another, then the figure is not symmetrical about that line. Let's see the examples of asymmetry. Children, now look at this figure. The fold along the line in the Christmas tree divides it into two parts, which does not fall exactly on one another. So, the Christmas tree is asymmetrical with respect to this line. Children, now in this figure, two parts made by a line do not fall exactly on one another. Then the figure is asymmetrical about that line. Children, in this figure, English alphabet G is not symmetrical with respect to the dotted line, because one half does not cover the other half. Children, now look at this figure. Here, two parts of a figure made by a line do not fall exactly on one another. So, the figure is asymmetrical about that line. Children, now look at this figure. Here, the fold along the line in the triangle does not fall exactly on one another. Means, one half does not cover the other half. So, the figure is asymmetrical about that line. Children, what do you see in this picture? Yes, this is a picture of an apple. In this figure, the fold along the dotted line in the apple divides it into two parts, which does not fall exactly on one another. Means, the apple is an asymmetrical with respect to this line. Children, can you tell me what is a closed figure? Don't worry, I will tell you. A geometrical figure that begins and ends at the same point is called a closed figure. Here you can see the examples of closed figure. Children, can you tell me what is an open figure? If the two ends of a geometrical figure are not joined, then the figure is called an open figure. Now let's see the examples. The letter C, the letter S, and the letter U are the examples of an open figure. Children, now it's time for the exercise. And you will be doing this exercise in your maths notebook. Question 1. Determine whether the figures given below are symmetrical about any line or not. Put a tick below the figure if it is symmetrical, and a cross if it is not. Children, now it's time for the homework. For each of the figures below, draw a line along which you would fold the figure to show that it is symmetrical. Children, now it's time for the activity. Complete the drawing around the line of symmetry. Now, second activity, draw the other half of each symmetrical shape. One example is done for you. Children, here you have to find the open and closed figures from those given below. Thank you, children, for watching this video.